So now what in today's session, we'll start the configuration of this workflow and we'll see how we have to configure this workflow. So just remember, like since we are performing this like configuration of workflow on the like cloud solutions, and that is completely different as compared to our backend SAP system. So like, you know, in the backend SAP system that we have to configure like release strategy, we can configure like, you know, that classes or some like release code, but this is not required in the SAP Ariba. So here SAP has given some like, you know, the predefined conditions and some other parameter. So based upon the our requirement, what we have to do, we have to basically just select or we have to configure that particular condition. Okay, so if you see in our example, so let me just open this notepad. So in this one, that for the label one, that the customer requirement is that workflow should go to the manager of the PI creator. Okay, so manager means the supervisor. So in the first case, that the customer is looking that whoever is creating the requisition, system has to trigger the workflow to the his supervisor. So for that, what we have to do, so let's start this configuration. So once we will start the initial level configuration, so here that we can see that a system has automatically added one first approval node. And in the first approval node means like this is the first level, and here we can configure our approval information. So in the next step, we have to move to the approval rule editor, and here we have to specify this rule title and the rule description. So we have to give rule title. So basically rule title and rule description is completely free text field, and whatever information that we would like to put here, we can simply put. Okay. So what I will do, I will give some hypothetical example here. In the rule title, I'll give this supervisor label, or it is already there. Same way, same information I will keep in this rule description as well. Okay, so basically whatever that information that you will specify in the approval rule editor, the same information will also be available in the approval node. So we can see we have given the supervisor label in the under rule title, and we can see in the node also it is showing as the supervisor label. Okay, so if you want to keep the more description, we can specify the more description based on the our requirement. And since in this case we do not have any condition, it is very straightforward. So in that case, we have to skip this condition. So this condition part will not come in the picture here, and we have to move to the action. So in the action, we can see, as we discussed earlier as well during our template configuration, that we have the two options here in the action. That one is the add approvers and group, and second one is the use approval lookup table. So basically use approval lookup table is a kind of custom table. So how, like if that we have to implement some kind of custom table based on some parameter of the approval workflow, then only we have to use this approval lookup table. We'll talk about this approval lookup table. Before that, we have to set the first approver. So here in the type, we can see we have the option that adds approvers and group. So whenever we will have the requirement that to select a particular, you know, that manager or particular approver or like, you know, that particular group. So in that case, we have to select this add approvers and group. Okay, so we'll keep as it is, like since it is automatically coming in selected mode, and we have to move to the action step. And in the action, that we can see in the drop down. So if you click on this drop down, we have multiple options here. So like we can see add group, add approver based on field in approvable, add supervisor, add requester, add approver based on Plex master data lookup. So like this, we have the different option. So whatever that option is relevant to us, that option we have to select here. So in our case, that we have to add the supervisor. So what we have to do, we have to select here as the add supervisor. That means we are going to add this manager. Okay. And in the parameter, we have the two options, approval required and region. So these two parameters already we discussed during our template configuration. So just I'm giving high level like information. So approval required means we have to select this checkbox. That means that particular manager will be approvable. And in case if the manager is the observer, we have to uncheck this checkbox. And in the region field, we can specify like, you know, any kind of text like must approved, kindly approved, whatever. So like this, that we have to specify a straightforward, simple workflow here. Okay. Any question here?
No, Rohit.
All right. Okay. All right.
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay. So this is something first level approver. Now we have to move to the next level approver. So in case of the next level, if you see that our example, so here we are going to the second level, and in this case, the overflow should go to the procurement manager if PR amount is in between like 1000 to the 10,000. So that means that we are going to send this overflow to the procurement manager, but in case the PR amount is will be like, you know, that if the this condition will be true. So this is basically your condition. So if the PR amount will be true, in that case only it will route to the procurement manager. So that means in the second level, we have to also incorporate the conditions as well as the group as well, right? So procurement manager is the group, not a particular, you know, that ID. So in that case that we have to incorporate both the things, we have to incorporate the group, and we also have to incorporate that, you know, this conditions as well, and condition is based on the amount. So for this, if you go in the system,